Hello, my name is Julie Johnson, and I am the president for the Rock Island Arsenal Association of the United States Army Chapter, and I have the great pleasure of being with Staff Sergeant Shiloh Harris this evening. I just asked for a few minutes of his time so that he can tell us a little bit about his story. I want you to get to know him, and then we've got something special planned. So, sir, please, if you can tell us just a little bit about yourself.
Well, thank you very much. I'm very proud to be interviewed for AUSA and getting to meet you. Of course, we've met a few times already.
Yes, sir.
And we have some friends in common. So honestly, I didn't know that you were affiliated with AUSA. So I get to learn something new every day. But thank you very much.
Absolutely. So I know that a day in February of 2007 changed your life forever. Could you tell us just a little bit about that, sir?
Yes, ma'am. I was injured by a roadside bomb in Iraq in 2007, February 19th, and I was working in the southern area of Baghdad. I don't know, probably a lot of people that's gonna be watching this know that area. Right around Yusufia, Mamadia, real crap hole, you know, just so you know.
Okay.
But I don't always say that, just so you know. That area was riddled with IEDs. We got a call to investigate a possible IED in that area, and generally, y'all know what that means. You know, we gotta get over there, secure the site, make sure nobody gets injured, and then call for the engineers to come in and potentially remove it or investigate. Now, on our way to that site, I was the third truck in the convoy, and my Humvee was hit with about 700 pounds of explosives buried in the road. I lost three soldiers that day, and my driver and I were the only two that survived by God's grace. Now, I've had, to date, about 70-something surgeries. You know, this happened over 10 years ago, so I've had a bit of a recovery time. But as a burn survivor, I see that there's gonna be maintenance and things that I have to deal with for the rest of my life, just as any severely injured service member. But I still feel very blessed.
Now, you've talked about your faith a great deal, and you've talked about, I've heard you speak before, the pride that you have in having served your country. Once a soldier, always a soldier, they say. I'd like to see if you talk about how important it's been for you to be in that role.
I believe that it's important, not just for me, to be able to serve. I think it's important for so many other service members and veterans, you know, that separate from the military. I think that it's important that they find what it is that's gonna give them purpose again in their lives. I believe that that's one of the reasons that we have so many suicides now, because there's so many young men and women getting out of the military, either damaged mentally or physically or both, that perhaps they lose sight of those important things in their life and the many blessings that they have in their life. Me being able to get up on stage and share my story, it's not about me. It's not about glorifying me. It's not about, you know, acting like I did something more in the military than what I did. You know, I served honorably, I'm proud of my service. I have no regrets behind it. When I get up on stage, I'm a soldier and I represent professionalism. I represent the men and women that have donned the uniform. And I represent, obviously, myself and my family. And coming from a family of veterans, it's important to me to represent that legacy, you know, for many years to come. And I try to instill that same thing in my children. But service seems to be the key word here. You know, I'm able to serve, whether it be a civilian audience that I'm educating on how to welcome veterans home, or whether it's other veterans out there that need to find that purpose in their life. I'm hopefully going to give them what they need to take that step in the right direction.
I'm so glad you brought up that word service. It's so important. I don't know if I've shared this with you, but my grandfather, William Johnson, is a World War II veteran. He's part of the liberation of the Philippine Islands. And, you know, when I was growing up, talk to me about serving your country any way you can. We talked about the Association of the U.S. Army and said thank you for becoming a new member. Perhaps renewing your membership, we'll have to look at that. But we talked about how it's the voice for the Army. It's an advocate for our soldiers, for our veterans, for family members, and for the civilians that also serve at a variety of installations and roles all over the world to support our warfighter. Wondered if you could just take a moment and talk about how important it is to support these types of organizations and to serve any way you can.
Absolutely. Obviously, you know how important that is, you know, with your family's legacy as well. And then, of course, what you do now. You know, being in the military, you're part of an organization. You're part of one of the leading military forces in the world. Whether it be Army, Marines, Air Force, Coast Guard, Navy, you know, you're part of a team. And when you separate from the military, you know, some men and women are okay with, you know, going home and being with family and just settling back in. You know, but others, there's a lot of us that still need to feel like we're part of a team. These organizations give that sense of stability and support that so many of us need. And I didn't mean us, I need it. I feel like I need to be a part of something greater than myself, just like I was a part of the Army. I was a part of a platoon, I was a part of a squadron, I was part of the division. These things filled me up. They helped me feel successful because I was contributing to a better cause and a stronger cause, leading cause. These organizations still have that opportunity with so many men and women. They're changing lives and they're needed. They're absolutely needed in so many ways.
So for soldiers and for veterans to be a part of, you know, the professional organization for the United States Army, it's one thing, it's a privilege to be a part of a professional organization like that. But for a civilian like me, you know, I have found it's also really a way that I can support and show my military, our military, you know, where I stand. So I appreciate your comments on that. I guess one final question that I have, you know, so many of the great messages you've shared and the many times that I've met with you have really been about taking that moment and making the next best choice, whatever that means for you, but not giving up. You're an example of steel will. I wonder if you could just speak to that, to big veterans, to active duty, to anybody out there that may be struggling right now and needs to hear that from a man like you.
You had to have the will to join the military. You had to have the will to put your life on the line, because that's exactly what you did. When you signed your name to that military organization, whichever one it was, and in this particular case, I believe I'm talking to the Army. You know, when you signed your name on that line, you said, I'm willing to give everything for my nation. You need to apply that same will to everything that you do. You need to go out there and live your life. Because believe me, I've hit bottom more than once. I've scraped bottom a couple times. I can tell you this, life is worth living. You need to go out there, grab onto it with both hands, and live life to the fullest. Find out what fills you up again.
That was wonderful. Well, I've one last thing for you. We are so fortunate at the Rock Island Arsenal to have our JMTC organization that makes everything from ammunition to ambulances and all the things in between. They made a challenge coin for us. And it's no small coin, but it was made from the scrap that was repurposed to find another life to represent the Rock Island Arsenal, DOD's Rock since 1862. And sir, I thank you for your service. It is my honor to present this challenge coin to you and to have any time to spend with you and get to know you. Thank you so much on behalf of the Rock Island Arsenal chapter of the Association of the United States Army. I present you this coin for your service and for your continued work for all people everywhere. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you all. Thank you all very much. This is amazing.
Thank you.
Would it be okay if I give you my coin now?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. I would love it. I mean, it's no small coin, I'll tell you that. But
which one do you want? I got two coins. I got a coin for badasses, and I got a coin for, you know, everybody else.
Who doesn't want to be a badass?
All right.
Thanks again. Thank you. This is wonderful. Thank you so much.
Yeah.